All right, we are live. All right, welcome back, everybody. Glad to see everybody once again. Surprise, surprise, Mr. Bob Say. Yes, you've heard him or you saw his text in the chat before. He is our upcoming GlobeEd.net instructor. He's going to be in GlobeEd. He's doing courses on there right now. He's got a YouTube channel, which, Bob, do you mind if I try to just look at it real quick?
Not at all. Bring it up.
All right. That's the wrong button. Hold on. IT, I tell you. Never thought they would have problems. There's Bob's YouTube channel. Now be careful when you type Bob's last name. It's S-E-A-Y. You type something different, you're gonna get a surprise, like I did today. Okay.
Or you can look at my teach the letter U, the number two network.
Let me type that in there. Teach U two network. All right. And they can do that on YouTube, right? They can
just YouTube and Facebook.
Okay, cool. All right. So he's on there. He's creating his stuff. So, Bob, you're a brand new addition to our family. You've been with me for a while in our chats, and I appreciate you 100%. So tell us, what do you have for us? Well first, tell us about yourself. I'm sorry. Tell us about yourself, and then tell us what you got for us.
Well, my name is Bob. I've been working in the networking field for about 10 years now. I work for a cable company, and I just, you know, Laz was my teacher years ago, and I see what he's done with himself and the students that he's gathered, and he has his platform on GlobeEd.net, and we discussed the fact that he's looking for other instructors. So I took him up on his opportunity. I decided, you know what, I can do that, and it's been a passion of mine to try to get involved in it. So I decided then, why not? So I'm in the process right now of working on a CCNA course. It's going to take me a while to get it done. But as I'm doing it, I'm putting these videos on YouTube and also on Facebook so that people can get a glimpse, a sneak peek, sneak preview of what I'm going to be doing. Now, I'm not putting the entire course on YouTube, obviously. I'm just putting good little bits of information on there to help people learn. And I'm going from the very basics, from the bottom of it, for somebody that doesn't know or understand networking, to the most advanced CCNA material there is.
That's awesome. You're bringing it. And that's one key word that you said that I like. And that's what attracted me to you, is the fact that you have a passion to teach. When you said that, I was like, oh, okay, this guy needs to come on board. Because that is what I think everybody needs to have, is a passion for what they do. You have a passion. I'm sorry, go ahead.
No, I was just agreeing with you. Absolutely. I mean, if you don't have a passion for what you're doing, then you're not going to enjoy what you're doing. I mean, I've been in the networking field for 10 years, and I've really enjoyed what I'm doing, and I love my job. And I know that there's a lot of people out there that struggle with being able to pay for the courses. So I figured, you know, I learned this way by watching you on YouTube, and I bought your course years ago, and you know, and we've become friends over the years, and I see a good thing here. And you know, you have that fundraiser that you're doing right now, which, you know, I'm hoping everybody goes out there and donates for that. I'll let Laz talk about that more. But yeah, I mean, you got to have a passion for what you do. If you don't have a passion for it, then you're just going to go about it, you know, you're not going to love it. You're not going to enjoy what you're doing.
Exactly. I mean, and you have, obviously you have a passion for networking because you've been in that one of the largest cable companies, right? Cable company, is that correct?
Correct.
So you've been there for 10 years. Okay. So you have to have a passion for it, because if you keep doing something you hate for 10 years, you'll be one bitter individual, and that is not you.
Absolutely. No.
Okay. So definitely that's great. And then you have a passion for teaching. That's what you expressed to me. And it shows in the way that you teach. I've seen your videos on YouTube, and they're excellent. They're excellent videos. Everybody go see it, because it's straight to the point. I think Bob is like that. What is it? The new IT is bald and goatee.
The new IT is bald and goatee.
There you go. That's what Bob says. Okay? And the whole thing is that people look at us and we don't look like your normal IT person. We look like, you know, the guy that's going to be a bouncer, or we're going to, you know, it's like the rough, rugged, but he knows his stuff. So now he's bringing it to everybody else, because he understands the struggle that he went through, that struggle that I went through to get into this field. And he's going to be giving you the information you need from A to Z. Absolutely. So he's here to help you. He's here to help you. And you can check out his Facebook, his YouTube, all right, that teach you to network. You look at that and then you can see more or less what he's teaching. And you're going to see it's no fluff. Because I've seen your videos and they're pretty straight to the point. Even though, you know, it's beginning videos right now, you're getting started. But mm-hmm. that's awesome. Because one of the things that people don't do, and you tell me what you think about this. You've been given an opportunity, right? But I've given opportunities to a lot of people and they don't take action on it. You did.
Right.
So it's not just having, okay, you know the saying, opportunity knocks only once and you took it. You know what I mean? And you ran with it. I mean, you got a Facebook, you got a YouTube, and you're working on your courses. I mean, can you talk a little bit about that as far as, you know, taking action, not just, you know, saying, yeah, I want to get certified. Can you more or less help us understand, not just, okay, let me just get all these certifications, but enjoy what I'm doing. And hey, I need to go ahead and take action on that.
Well, speaking from somebody who went to college and got a degree in computer networking, you know, it got me in the field. It did. But you know what I did? I worked in a warehouse for years working with computer equipment. I wasn't doing the networking. I wasn't working on routers. I wasn't working on switches. But it got my foot in the door to basically put these routers up on the shelf and stuff like that. That's not what I wanted, you know. And then I continued to push and continued to push and continued to interview. And a lot of times I wouldn't get the interviews because the degree didn't mean anything. I mean, nowadays you got the certifications. That's what employers are looking for. And if you look at the job boards like Indeed and stuff like that, Dice, almost every single job for a network engineer is saying at least a CCNA required. So with that being said, and you know, when I finally went and got my CCNA, that's exactly what happened. I mean, literally 2 months after I obtained my CCNA, I got the job that I'm in now. And
awesome.
I've been there ever since. I love it. And I've just continued to grow. I started out as a network engineer one, and I just continued to progress.
And see, I don't think that's what people understand. And thank you for that, because I don't think people understand that when you go to college, it's really a kind of a hands-off approach, I think. Because when I went to University of Miami, it's not, you know, it's not that one-on-one or that one-on-five, or they actually try to help you. It's like, you better figure this out on your own. You know, it's up to you. And I understand about taking responsibility. I mean, everybody should take responsibility for what they want to do, but they really need to do what you did. You say, okay, this is what I like. This is where I want to be. So what are the steps that I need to go through to make this happen? And you saw that Indeed, you mentioned Indeed and Dice, that everybody was asking for a CCNA. So you said, okay, I need to get my CCNA. So yeah. You got your CCNA, boom. 2 months later, there you are. 10 years later, here you are at one of the largest cable companies that we have here in the U.S. So that's awesome. So yep. You are a success story. You are a person that said, I'm going to do this, and I'm going to move forward, and I'm going to take action on what I need to do. So that's I think that's freaking awesome. It's
and
hard.
That's what you have to do. You got to take responsibility for yourself. You got to, you know what the world wants, know what the employers want, and go for it. You know, and that's where me and you come in, Laz. We're the guys that, you know, want to teach this, have a passion for it, love doing it, and just want to share our knowledge that we've gained exactly. over the years.
You know? Yeah. No, go ahead. I'm just agreeing with you. It's true. I like what you're saying.
Yeah. And I'm just saying, you know, I mean, ever since I've been putting this stuff on YouTube and Facebook, I have people reaching out, asking me questions. And, you know, I don't care what kind of question it is. It could be the most simplest. It could be the most complex. If I don't know the answer, I'm going to get the answer. Guess what? Me and Laz are good friends. I'll ask him if I don't know the answer.
I'm here for one another.
You know,
yeah, exactly.
So, and when I first got into the field, I was told by a couple engineers, oh, you know, there's some guys out there that, you know, they hoard the information. Yeah, you're going to come across that. You're going to come across that in anything. That's not me. That's not Laz. And that's not what GlobeEdNet is about. We want to share our knowledge. We want to share our wealth, and we want to help you in every way possible.
Exactly. Well said. And that's true. I did find it was very difficult for me. Okay, to go out there when I first started getting one. I was certified up and down, and to get a job was just ridiculous. But you got to keep going. You got to keep striving. You got to keep moving. You got to keep moving. You know, you got to be at least 1% better than the day before. You know, am I better than I was yesterday? And I, one of the things I said in my life is, it's a military saying that says the only easy day was yesterday. And that's true because, you know, you already went through it. We don't know what the future holds. We know what we want. Now we just got to set those steps. And they don't have to be large steps. Little by little, little by little, little by little. But one of the things that, you know, I don't know if you realize it yet. I think you have. Not only is teaching what you know, because you're in the field. You're still in the field. You work and you're trying to do this. Like mm-hmm. when I started, I was working and doing this, but now I just do this full time. Okay. It's rewarding it feels good when students come and ask you, hey, Bob, hey, Laz, hey, whoever. How do you do this? Man, if it wasn't for you, you know, I saw your video, Bob, and wow, a light bulb just came on. That moment, that is so rewarding. Yes, we need our jobs. We need everybody to get paid. Understood. But isn't it great to do something that actually you're passionate about? You enjoy it. Not only are you passionate about educating people, not only are you passionate about what you're educating them on, you're changing people's lives. And then on top of that, a student, that's going to be you. You can have 100, 200, a million students. And out of those million students, maybe 50 come back and say, Bob, man, it was you. It was you, the one that changed my life around. That right there is going to be like, it's more fulfilling than anything in the world. It really is, emotionally. And just to know that somebody out there, you changed their life. I think you realize that already when all these people are reaching out to you.
I do. I mean, I have people reaching out and just asking questions right now. But I mean, I can concur with a perfect example of that.
Okay.
I when I first started studying in CCNA, I was having a difficult time with learning subnetting. I was reading the book, the Cisco Press book, and no matter how much I read it, no matter how many times I practiced it, I just couldn't understand it. Well, then I found this guy, Lazaro Diaz, who he explained it and broke it down in a way that it just clicked, you know, and when it clicked, I was like, wow, this is amazing. So I was already a self-study CCNA guy. I was already reading the books. And I said, if this guy can explain subnetting the way that he did and make me understand it in a matter of minutes, there's got to be something that I can gain from him. So that immediately made me go out and buy your course. Then I went through the whole course and everything, and it's just phenomenal. I mean, I credit a lot of my success to what you've put out there. And I can't wait for a situation where I have somebody doing the same with me. And, you know,
I can guarantee you, Bob, knowing you and speaking to you for all this time that, you know, thank you very much, first of all, but you are a very self-disciplined individual. You have the discipline, you have the commitment, all right, to move forward, to strive forward. I've seen your beautiful family, all right? So you have a family to support, okay? So you said, hey, I better grow up and not grow up, but I better, you know, toughen up and do what I need to do and get where I need to be and do the things that will get me to where I need to be. And you did it. So it's just not enough, because it's a saying that goes, when the teacher appears or when the student appears, the teacher will appear, something like that. It's something to do with that, you know, I can stand, you don't know how many, because I started in the brick and mortar. Right. And they had me there live in person. And you have no idea how many people squandered. Not to say that I'm, ooh, you know, whatever. But it's like, come on, man. I've always been the same way. I've never changed. I'm like, hey, here, yeah, what do you need to know? What do you need to know? What do you need to know? And I've taken, you know, students from just sitting around not doing anything. Hey, come in the classroom. Let's play around with the network. So, but you got to have the desire. I can put the plate in front. It's like you can eat a horse of water, but you can't make a drink. Yep. You know, I can show you. I can teach you. I can do many things. But if you don't take yours, if you're not disciplined, if you don't take it to where you took it, yeah, I can teach you all day. It doesn't matter. It doesn't really matter. So you took that and you ran with it, which this is why it's going to make you, you're going to be a great instructor. And I can see it already in your videos that you're straight to the point. You explain perfectly what needs to happen. So what if this is, and you're starting from the very beginning. I'm looking at this side because I'm looking at your videos. I mean, you start from the very, very beginning. Telnet, you got switching a MAC address, fixing interfaces, pinging host names. You got all this, which is, DNS and all that stuff. So you start from the very, little nothing. And then but that is so important, yeah. Which is foundation. And you'd be surprised because right now, Bob, you know what's going on in the certifications where people are skipping Network Plus and CCNA and they're going straight to CCNP and they don't have that foundation at all. They don't have that foundation and they're lost. And if they go into your job right now, come on, man. Well, I think we talked about this already. How many people have come to you in your job and you're like, okay. How many times? Tell me that. Give me not saying where you work or the person's name or anything, but what examples can you tell me that you've seen at your workplace or in the work area in the field that things happen that you're like, why is this happening? This person has this.
It happens every day. I mean, that's what we're doing, you know. I mean, that's why we're IT, you know, and that's what I love so much about where I work at is that every one of us just use ideas to bounce off of each other. And when I have an issue, I got the guy next to me that I could talk to. And when he has an issue, he comes to me. And every one of us have a little bit of knowledge about every part of the subject. None of us know it all. But if we come together and work together as a team and put our heads together, we can get anything accomplished. And that's why we do work for one of the best cable companies in the world and why during the pandemic we were considered an essential company. And it was amazing how much the bandwidth just increased tremendously during the pandemic, and we kept up with it, you know, and our workload pretty much quadrupled. And And it was unbelievable how we all came together, and we were working from home. You know, everybody was working from home, and that's why the bandwidth continued to rise. You know, you had everybody working from home using their own internet bandwidth, and we had to make sure that there was enough there.
Yeah, and that's the thing right now. Even I mean, me giving boot camps and stuff like that, or my wife putting, you know, doing whatever she does in the administration side of our company. I tell her, listen, you just understand right now on the internet, the ISPs, depending on where you're at, can handle the bandwidth because of the pandemic that the kids weren't going to school. You have people working from home. All right. Your regular everyday internet traffic of people going to Facebook, YouTube, watching price, whatever it was, movies. Well, the consumption of movies went up.
Last.
All right. Huh? Hello? Hello? Oh, there you are. There you are. I heard your voice and I was like, but all right, you know, I'm saying the movie consumption went up, right?
Yes.
Because everybody's at home and what have you. And one of the things that I have to say it, I gripe about, why are we using IPv6? Why are we using IPv6? Why are we using IPv6? Why are we not using ISIS? These are protocols that are going to streamline things, are going to scale things better. So they're not doing this. They're just increasing frames and what have you. I'm paying $100 a month for 1 gigabit, and I get throttled, if not every week, every other week, or every 2 to 3 weeks, from 1 gig to 100 megabits per second. All right? Yep. And I've already called out people to come out here to look at it. And the last person that came out here was pretty knowledgeable. It was pretty cool talking to an individual like that. And that's what I mean. You know, you have people that field technicians or people like yourself that work in-house. Mm-hmm. For them to have that knowledge, for them to have that Cisco knowledge. And again, don't be scared, because if I go into your job, I got to say, hey, Bob, man, how do you do this?
Yep.
You know what I mean? And you'll share your knowledge. And I had a good experience with that. And I'm sure you did as well. Or else you wouldn't have been there for 10 years. You haven't been there for 10 years. So how is the CCNA? Where are you at right now? Where everybody's excited. Everybody's getting ready to see your courses up there. Like I did with Jolie, because yeah, Jolie's up there, Louis is up there, the Meraki, no, Microtech, Thomas Lab is up there. Adam will soon have his course up there. So you're coming in now. We need that course. And yeah. Cisco, awesome.
Yeah, I'm working on it right now. What I'm doing is basically making a course 85% of labs. Now, I know that Cisco recently took labs out of their CCNA. Why, I don't know, but they did. But, all right, you go there and you pass the CCNA on a multiple choice question or a drag and drop question. But when you get out in the real world, if you don't know how to configure it, you ain't going to – you're not going to keep your job.
No, anyway, exactly.
The point is that I'm putting the labs out there. I'm putting the configurations out there. Yeah, I'm going to talk a little bit about theory. But for the most part, I just want to show you what it's like. And Packet Tracer is beautiful, you know. Packet Tracer allows us to not have to go out and buy an expensive router, an expensive switch, and all the cables and all that. And we literally simulate a network right there. And it's, you know, you bring up that window, that it looks like a regular PuTTY window. It's the same exact thing. So, and I'm using that, and people can download it. It's a free application that Cisco provides. And I'm just going to continue to put labs on there. And now you asked me about the course. I'm currently doing the course. I'm probably maybe a quarter of the way through volume one, because it is a two-volume book, volume one and volume two book. I'm probably about a quarter of the way through volume one, and I'm going to be working on that and doing it as much as possible. Now, I am a family man. I have four kids at home. I work full time. So it's not coming out tomorrow.
but that's not gonna happen.
That's the beauty of YouTube. You know, as I'm finishing videos and finishing the editing, I'm putting them on YouTube, allowing people to get a glimpse of what they're going to get when they actually have an opportunity to pay for the full entire course.
Exactly.
And I'm guessing, you know, within the next few months. I can't put a guaranteed date on that yet. But the closer it gets to it, you know, I'd like to do this again in like a month or so, where we can go live and talk and discuss where I'm at with it. And then right before the launch of the course, you know, we'll do it again. And I'll say, all right, now I can give you a solid date of when it's going to be available.
Well, the whole thing is that now, let me put this back up here. Now that people got your YouTube, you can actually set it up to do, because you do the same thing. You can just set up your YouTube and do that as well. Or we can go through mine. It doesn't really matter.
Right. But,
so you can go ahead and do that stuff. And Mike, by the way, Mike Barrett says, yep. Hello, Bob. He said, hi. I said, hi, Mike. All right. People think it's just easy to create a course. I'm sure you're finding out it's not that easy. And every instructor that I had, you know, that I've come, you know, except I guess for the exception of Joel, he got his class up real quick. But he used to teach with me in the career colleges. He used to teach with me as well. So okay. He has experience in education. And I think Lewis did a pretty decent job getting something out there pretty quick. He's a smart young man. He's in New Mexico. He's an administrator at 20, dude. He's 24, I think now, 23. I keep missing. Oh, wow. Yeah, young guy, even younger than Adam. And he's an administrator in a government database that they told him, hey, you need to automate this. So he had to learn Ansible on its own. So the course he put up was Ansible for Network Engineers on Globet. And he got up there pretty quick. But Adam saw that it wasn't just cut and dry to do a course. So, yeah, and you're right. You know, we're looking for instructors left, right, you know, everything. But I'm going to be putting out a course on how to do this. But I think I'm going to go live. I've scheduled myself to go live, I think, next week. I don't know. I never schedule myself. I schedule myself, and then when I get the thing, I just go on sometimes.
I know. I get notified every other week or so, and I got to hop on there just to say what's up to you.
Yeah. It's like because I'm doing so many projects right now that, I mean, like, again, when I look up, it's because I got a freaking monster of a calendar up there. And it's just, you know, it's just a lot of things that I'm trying to get done and try to get out there. And I got to get my certifications, get recertified again, because yep. Like I've been teaching and doing boot camps. And it's like, okay, what about me? But definitely now, you know, now it's, you know, you can now speak from experience, and as far as in the educational side of things, that it's not easy to put up a course. So nobody can expect you to decide, hey, why don't you have the CCN up yet in 2 weeks? Because it doesn't work that way. It doesn't work that way. So if you want something with substance, And because Bob is not going to read to you a bedtime story. Like, I'm not going to read to you a bedtime story. He's going to show you. He is an engineer. He is going to show you how to do things. This is a man with 10 years of experience and out working, you know, at the low level of networking. He's working at the upper echelon level of networking. So he knows what he's talking about. So definitely he's going to be a very good resource to have. So definitely go look at his YouTube channel, Teach You to Network, or you can do his name, Bob Say, S-E-A-Y. All right, don't mistype it. Hold on, because they better not mistype it. Hold on. I'm going to refresh this page. I'm going to get this right here, because if they mistype it, they're going to get a surprise, and hopefully their kids are not in the room. Okay? I'll put that link right there. Okay? It's in the chat, because if not, it'll be an issue. But this is the type of instructors that GlobeEd looks for. People like yourself, Jolie, Adam, security, excellent IT person, excellent security individual, very professional. Okay. He knows his stuff, and he will create, again, he did what you're doing. He's doing a real world type scenario. I can tell you, I mean, I don't know if you looked into it or not, as far as the, because you see the new CCNA, you've taken the older, I think it was the 125, right?
Yeah, the 200, 125, yes.
So this new CCNA, I think, and I said this before, and I'll say it now, I guess, Cisco is trying to improve our vocabulary, not improve our networking skills, it's trying to improve our vocabulary. Because, I made fun of Spurious, you know that.
I know.
So, but I'm looking at lecturers so I can be more articulate. And that lecturer said the word spurious. And it just lit me up. I was like, what? Mm-hmm. So I'm like, okay. So I finally looked up the definition of spurious. And that's what it is. It's fake. Something right. That's fake, something that's not real. So Cisco is trying to make us more articulate in networking. But when it comes to the actual topics, I don't know if you looked at the new books or not.
I have the new books.
You have the new books?
Yep.
If you look at them, you know, and you start really going through the fine print, it's like, what the hell? Mm-hmm. You're like, go ahead, please. I want your comment on that. I mean, what do you think about the newer stuff?
Well, I think that, they still have a lot of the basics in there and a lot of the good stuff that's in there. But, you know, they're definitely obviously going towards automation, which is great. You know, I mean, automation is good, but let me ask you this. If you're an automation guy and you got your CCNA based off of learning the automation, and then some sort of hardware breaks down or something happens with the configuration that your automation process can't handle, who's going to fix that? You're not going to. Yeah, you're going to look for somebody else that knows, that studied the right material, the beginning stages of it. It's almost like when you study Microsoft, you know, nobody knows what DOS is, but they're going to tell you what DOS is as the progression goes, because you got to know where Microsoft started to get to where they are. And it's the same thing with Cisco. You know, this automation stuff is good, but it's not true engineering. And in order to be a true engineer, you got to know what you're doing from the inside and out. And that's what we're teaching. We're teaching everything. You know, I'm going to get to the Ansible stuff and automation stuff, because that's part of the test. Our goal here is to help you pass the test. But I'm going to give you real world experience of what is needed. Is, you know, you can get that piece of paper, which is great because it's going to get you the interview. But once you're in that job, you need to know what you're doing. You know,
exactly.
So you can't just count on the automation process. You got to know the nuts and bolts of it.
Exactly. And I can tell you this right now. I'm perfectly transparent, perfectly honest, because this is in volume two when I get into the Ansible, Chef, Puppet, JSON, REST APIs, all that stuff. You're not going to be configuring anything, ladies and gentlemen. And I'm not a programmer. We're going to look through the chapter. Like, if you go to my live bootcamp, we can go through the chapters and I'll point certain things out. Read it. That's a part of the book that you can read, that you can get the definitions, you can learn the terminology, more or less gain the concept. We can help you with the concept. But I speak for myself. I'm not a programmer. I never was. I will learn, obviously. That will be something that I will tackle and learn Ansible and learn Python. I've already taken certain courses in that. Okay, so I can become a better engineer. But the good thing between Bob, myself, and all the guys that I have teaching, they have their courses up, or they will have their courses up on GlobeEd, is that they are engineers already, whether it's security, network, whatever it is, whatever part of IT they're in, they have that foundation. All right. So we, like me, I come from the school of DOS. Okay. Mm-hmm. I come from, you know, back in the day of ISDN, dial up, all that stuff, T1s. So I've grown with all this, and I'm going to continue to grow. I'm not going to stop striving to learn more, and neither should anybody out there. Bob is not going to, because Bob wants to maintain his level and then go higher and go higher and go higher. And my goal for Bob, I'll be honest with you, Bob, I got a goal for you, bro. My goal is that Bob can actually do his education full time and maybe do contract jobs. That's my goal, Bob. I want you here full time. and then do contract jobs whenever, because contract jobs are easy to come by. And especially if you get a contract job to teach a company, mm-hmm. you know what I mean? Or because that's how I got into Metro. I taught them the CCNA. Mm-hmm. And then they say, hey, you want a job? I was teaching, making 30 grand, no, 40 grand. 40 grand a month at a technical school. 40 grand a month. I wish. 40 grand a year. Okay. At a technical institution, teaching it was 8 to 12, 1 to 5, and 6 to 10, right? 3 shifts, all right? And that's what I was getting paid. When these guys offered me, I'm like, oh, yeah, because it was double my income, all right, just going to that. But I got in through there. But once I found this online stuff and I saw what I could make even more, even better. And then as far as telecommunications, where I was at, did I get a feeling of this is where I want to be? It was when I first got there. You know what I mean? Because mm-hmm. I was able to go inside the routers, create sites manually and all that stuff. But then when T-Mobile came around and they automated the process, I was just uploading a file. That just took the love for what I do gone. But luckily, we found this, you know what I'm saying? And like everybody knows, I started in Udemy and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. And then I just move on to GlobeEd.net and what have you. But I had the educational background, and there's nothing I think more rewarding than that. Obviously, we need to get paid, but definitely contract jobs, it's easy to get. I went to Canada. I think you know this. I think I told you this. I went to Canada and taught the water. Their CISSP, 15 years, whatever, it was alive. I'm going to get into that. But I went to Canada to teach in Alberta University. I went to, there's another company called Modcom. Here, it was in Miami. The Assurant Group did a contract for them. The military base in Colorado. I think that's where you're at right now, Colorado.
Yep.
Okay. So I went to many different places to do contract jobs, and it pays very well. So, and right now, I don't keep up with the news. I really don't. I don't have time to be playing around. And listening to stupidity.
But you went on that rant a few weeks ago about that gas company that was hacked.
Well, guess what got hacked again? Guess what got hacked now?
What got hacked now?
All the beef manufacturers that it's a quarter of the beef that they supply. They're hacked. See, this is Microsoft was without email, because guess why? Unless you read about it, it came out in my, because I have a the Daily Planet, the Cisco Daily Planet. That's my mm-hmm. newspaper, right? The newsletter, and it came out in my newsletter, the Cisco Daily Planet, that Microsoft email stopped working. Take a wild guess. What do you think? Why people employees could not access their email platform? whatever you want to say, say it, because you're not going to get it. You're not going to get it because it's the most stupidest thing that
I didn't see the article. So
they didn't update their certificate. So they didn't update their certificate. So now it's that you get that warning. Hey, this is not a secure site. Boom. So all the other security tech stores, all it's not a secure site. You're not going anywhere. So they were down, and it cost a lot of money. See, people don't understand that. People don't get that. That's why you have to be knowledgeable. So, dude, when I heard that what do you mean they didn't update their certificate? Mm-hmm. A private company, a small mom and pop store. Okay, I mean, if you look on the internet now, I remember when I came around. I mean, look at StreamYard. I can right click right here on the little lock and look at their certificate, which is valid, and it's good for a year. It's good for a year. Okay, their certificate is good for a year. Okay, and back in the day, I remember, well, you can use your certificate for 15 years, 20 years. Oh, great, do it once and don't touch it again. No, that's not the way you do things. But now, a lot of these internet sites like Google, it's like 6 months. So I don't know Microsoft, because Microsoft, I remember back in those days, I'm talking about, let's say 2000, all right? Somebody actually walked into their building and stole certificates. They took it from their computer, and they were forging Microsoft SSL certificates. Oh, how about that one? So talk about physical security. And now they don't update their certificates? Come on, man. That's like, you know, I'll fire you because of that. Because come on. Oh, I'm sorry, my wife put it out there. The loss was about 5,000 per minute.
Wow.
That's insane. And see, that's what people don't understand. There, it doesn't necessarily take the whole network to get down to cost you money. Mm-hmm. You can have your network up 90%. I think when I taught wireless, I found some quote somewhere, okay, or some stat that said that some IT people in certain companies, they spent their whole 8 hours, or let's say a good portion of their 8 hours, changing username and passwords. And it was costing, I think, you know, and as far as, you know, they did maybe the United States, it was like, I want to say $300,000 a year.
Wow.
Just on changing, because people don't, okay. They say not to write down your password. Understood. Right. Okay. But if you are going to write it down, because look, okay. So if I write down my passwords, okay, I put them in a place where it's not underneath my keyboard, it's not taped on, it's not a sticky note on my laptop or anything like that. I have it in my wallet, I have it in my, you know, in my somewhere. Okay, so you need to do stuff like that because you understand that you're taking somebody's time.
Right.
You know what I mean? And that they could be doing something else more productive. I'm sure, I don't know, do people like where you work, do you take customer calls?
No, not in my department, we don't, no.
So you just based on, you know, you just make sure that the infrastructure and everything else stays up, right?
Yeah. I mean, we work with the inside plant, the outside plant, and we make sure that everything's working with the cable, make sure that we have enough IP addresses for customers and stuff like that. We monitor the network. We have software that tells us when we're about to hit a threshold of IPs. All right, I need to know how many IPs I'm going to add onto this router to make sure that we don't have an outage or anything like that.
Okay. See, that's in metro telecommunication was the same. In the switch, rarely we will get very rare. But sometimes you do get that customer because I don't know what the hell they have now. They had a, for voicemail, they have a particular software that you can access. See, people watch too many movies and they believe that. telecommunications, we can go into your phone and we can see everything in your phone. Now, if we do that for no reason, yeah, we're going to, because it's federal. We're at the federal level.
Right.
So that's a big deal. Don't be doing stuff like that because you're going to get in some major trouble. Mm-hmm. But we can go into your phone. We have to go into people's phones, reset their voicemails. Not me personally. I never did have to do that. The guys that were there did that. They showed me how to do it, but they showed, look, I can go in here and show you all your wife's texts. I go, show me. No, I didn't do that, babe. I didn't do that. But you can do that, you know what I mean? And but you're wasting people's time.
Right.
Because I can tell you that when I was there, we merged one switch that was further north from us. We merged it together. That was a work and a half, and I was doing about 100 sites, okay? Because I wanted to, because that's another thing. I saw people that didn't do what they're supposed to do. They're just hanging out for a paycheck. That's not you.
No.
That's not me, and that's not anybody that comes, any students that come to GlobeEd. That's not going to be you either, because we're going to put you to work. Okay,
yep.
We're gonna put you to work because it's our reputation on the line. If somebody says, "Well, Bob taught me, man. He didn't teach me everything," then you know Bob's gonna get a bad rep, man. And I don't think you want Bob chasing you down. You know, I don't think you want Bob chasing you down. Okay, he's a big guy. All right, so the thing is, all this information. Oh yeah, my newsletter. Yeah, it's called the Cisco Day Panel. My wife. Yeah, join, receive it in your inbox for free. Yeah, definitely. Just join it because that's I think it's irresponsible, don't you? I mean, as far as end users, isn't that like automated for security certificates and stuff like that?
Yeah, it should be. Why do you have to pay people to do that? It should be automated, and how can they not realize that they need to update their certificate? I don't understand that. So.
That's just crazy. That's insane. Exactly. That's just crazy. It's insane. But yeah, I mean, people just need to take responsibility. If they're coming into IT, they need to understand that this is a very important line of work. Mm-hmm. That's why I call myself the networking doctors, because we are doctors, because right. We will never stop studying. We will never stop learning.
Nope.
And we are your lifeline, because if your cell phone goes down, because the network went down, or you can't send an email, or some application is not working, or, you know, we communicate IT people all around the world in a computer, in their cubicle, they are making the world talk to each other. That's who we are. We communicate the world, and people take us, you know, for granted. And we're out there, I mean, you're out there every single day doing what you need to do to make sure that everything is working. You know what I mean? And now we're fortunate enough that you've been around already for a long time, and you know, we know each other, and you say, you know what, I'm gonna take a shot at this, and I'm gonna give people to actually you know, show them what I know, the real world scenario, what you're gonna confront when you're out there. But we have the same mentality, I think, when it comes, it's not just about getting the certification, correct? It's about
learning what you need to do. You know, I mean, the most important thing is your work ethic. You know, you got to get out there and you got to really enjoy what you're doing and have a passion for it, and always do the best. Always do the best that you can. I mean, yeah, that CCNA is going to get you the interview to get in there, but I mean, the CCNA is not going to pick you up and motivate you to go do what you have to do every day. That's you. You got to do that. And you know, that's not something that anybody can teach. That comes from you. That comes from inside you.
Exactly. So. Man, that's awesome. Ethics. Because that question was asked to me in the interview where, you know, what is your definition of ethics? And my response was doing my job while nobody's looking. That's all I had. You know what I'm saying? At the moment.
And that's like, perfect definition.
You know, it's like, I don't need a babysitter. I come here to do a function. I enjoy it, but I know that this needs to get done. All right. And now that you're in this side of the spectrum, as far as education, and you're not like when I was in the brick and mortar, you know, I know, okay, I got this class to teach. They give me my schedule. Okay, I got to prepare the syllabus, because the syllabus is one thing, the course outline, something else, the lesson plans. And I had to do all that. So I'm a freaking bunch of paperwork, which I hate. All right. But I learned to do that. So that was my responsibility. So I did that. I actually, you know, I started teaching when I was in the career college at 9 o'clock in the morning. I was in the campus at 7. Mm-hmm. So while everybody's running to get to work, I'm sitting outside having a coffee. Right. And I'm, because my board is ready, everything is ready. So I'm ready. And that's what people don't get. The paperwork, your portfolio. Nick is here. I'm studying cybersecurity using CompTIA's pathway, started from scratch at the beginning of 2020. Most important things to understood is networking, Laz Labs, IP book, Break Help. All right, Nick. Awesome.
Absolutely.
Doing Git and GitHub Labs now at the moment. Awesome. I've used Git, GitHub, but I'm glad I was able to help. Now you got to know. See, now this is cool. This is what I like. Now you got two Cisco people on there. All right. You got Bob and you got me. So you now you have two resources you can pull from. Maybe I'm saying something. You're like, what the hell is last thing? Let me check out Bob. Oh, okay. Listen, and that's happened to me. That's happened to me in the classroom where I'm telling the student, hey, this is this, this, and this. Man, I just don't get it. And then the student next one goes, bro, it means this, this, and this. Oh, okay, I get it now. And I'm standing up there. I'm like,
isn't that what I just said?
Exactly. Well, so,
I mean, go ahead. I even said something about that when we first got on here. I mean, yeah. I was studying and reading about subnetting and just couldn't get it. I was reading Todd Lamley's book and the way he explained it. And I was like, what is he talking about? I just couldn't get it. And then I saw you explaining it on YouTube. And I was like, wow, like you explained it in a way that nobody else ever explained it. And, you know, that wasn't the only instructor I had. That wasn't the only book I had. I went through countless number of books and had instructors in college that were struggling trying to teach me subnetting, and I just couldn't get it until I saw your video. So, and now that I know it and understand it, I go back and read those books, and I was like, wow. Like, you kind of feel like, whoa, why didn't I get it then? But there's always that one thing, that one person does that you relate to or something just clicks. And that's what happened with me and you, you know. And
dude, that's awesome. That is freaking awesome. And that's why I'm glad that you're teaching Cisco on GlobeEd. I welcome it because that gives the students now more resources that they can get from. So it's not just me, it's now you. And they have another Cisco instructor comes in. Perfect. Because it's you get different viewpoints from different people. That's just the way it is. That's just the way it is. You don't just use, I mean, be careful. There is such a thing, secrets of subnetting, the magic line. Well, it is. And I mean, they started calling that after I started doing it, Nick. Yeah. You know, and I don't know if I said it or not, but it's just that line, you know, because this is not rocket science. You don't need to know the physics behind this.
Right.
And anybody can learn syntax. Mm-hmm. Anybody can learn it. Right now, my Kevin, he's on here. And I give Kevin Hayes, the biggest props ever. In Kevin's, because I have one Monday, Wednesdays, and Tuesday, and Thursday. Kevin is in the Monday, Wednesday. He is doing things at a CCIE. This is supposed to be, people thought it was going to be just routing protocols. Oh, I know routing protocols. Yeah, no. Kevin is doing CCIE labs. We're doing... not only, okay, he understands IP addressing, right? We put the IP addresses, we run MPLS. Oh, we don't run MPLS, running ISIS, we run MPLS. We're doing BGP, but not as a routing protocol because we're doing route reflectors, we're doing route distinguishers, we're doing route targets, okay? So he's doing this, and that's awesome, you know what I mean? And that's awesome, so he's up there. But Kevin is the type of student he is so dedicated and passionate, and now, fortunately, it's a double-edged sword. Fortunately and unfortunately, now he's gotten way busy because he's getting a lot of work in. But now with his mindset that all the stuff that he's learned, he's been putting into use, which is awesome.
Right.
Okay. So, but listen, I love that fact that you're on here and you're going to put your course on here. And if you put an IP course, I love that too. So definitely everybody here is looking forward, ladies and gentlemen, for inglobed.net. You're going to be looking for Bob Say, okay? He's going to have his CCNA course on our platform as well. Please share your support. Go to his – I'm going to show your channel again, okay? Okay, go to his channel, all right? I put the link in there. Go to his channel, all right? He has some videos on there now, all right? So you can go ahead and see it. It may be – for some of you, maybe basic. For some of you, maybe not. But it's a starting point. For somebody that don't know anything, this is a good place to start, okay? Yeah.
And so, we're going to get more complex, you know, we're going through the whole book, the whole volume one and two. So we're going to get more complex. So if you get in there and it's stuff that you already know about, stick with me, you know, subscribe and click the bell. That way you're notified when a new video comes up. And maybe the next video I post is something that you need help with, something
that you're struggling with. That dude, every time I get up in the morning before I go to the gym, I look at my YouTube, right?
Mm-hmm.
Or comments, whatever. And one guy goes, man, because I'm doing a playlist. And he goes, Ben, the video you just put up is going to help me for my final in his college on Sunday. Mm-hmm. I'm like, oh, dude, that's awesome. You know, best of luck on your final.
Yeah, absolutely. You know what I
mean? And that's awesome that you will put something up that somebody's going to say, man, thank you so much. I just had to, because it's students that are in college. It's unfortunate, but that's the way it is. Mainstream colleges right now don't know what I don't want to say. Mainstream colleges are not doing what they're supposed to do, and students are lost. And you have no idea how many times, and you're going to hear it too, how many times instructors in colleges, the doctors and PhDs are in college, are teaching with subnetting with my video.
Yeah.
Okay.
I've heard that. Yeah.
So it's like, I don't mind it. That's great because they want to give them a good resource, all right, for the students to understand. But I can understand because I've used videos too. Okay, this is what he's doing here. And you can see, you know, I kind of explain. I just don't put the video and sit down and start smoking a cigarette, okay? Right. And that's what's going on. And that's not right because these people are paying. And that's why I don't get why you're still going to colleges. You come into GlobeEd.net, you're getting Bob's, you're getting mine, you're getting Joe's, you're getting all these people, and it's not – raping you, and you don't, when you leave, you still have a $60,000 debt or more. Okay, you know what I mean? They're
paying off mine.
You're still paying off money. You know what I mean? The years, they're taking your future money, they're taking your future self when you get to this high level. You still owe us $60,000, so you deferred it, so you need to pay that still. Or we're going to garnish your wages. What? So you don't want that. And that's why I think anybody that's getting into the IT field, this is the way to go. Unless your company is willing to pay for it, don't do it. Just get your certs, and you take the responsibility and dive in. Bob is going to be there. Bob is going to give you his 1,000% on everything you need. Okay?
And like I said earlier, I don't know the answer to a question. I have Laz. I have other instructors that I know. I have engineers that I work with every day that I could ask. I will find the answer for you if I don't know it. So please ask any questions that you may have.
And that's the attitude that you need to have. He has it as an engineer. He has it as an instructor and as a person, because he as a person himself wants to grow. Mm-hmm. Okay. And maybe you're going to ask him a question that he's never heard before in his life. All right. You're like, okay.
And you're going to help me. Because
exactly,
force me to go out and find the answer. So
exactly.
Now I'm doing something.
No, it's true. But it's true. We learn from each other. This is called networking, not only computers, but with people. So keep that in mind. Keep that in mind. All right. We're getting to the hour point. It's 52 minutes. Bob, anything you want to leave? Any words of inspiration? Any words of, you know, knowledge that you have that, or, you know, where your Facebook is and stuff like that you want to say before we... Get out.
Well, the Facebook page is the same as the YouTube. It's Teach, the letter U, the number 2, Network, all one word. Most of what is being posted on YouTube is also being posted on Facebook. The one thing I'm doing differently on Facebook, and I found that a lot of people are really liking it, is I'm putting Cisco or questions, CCNA-related questions on Facebook and allowing members of the group to answer, you know, and I'm not, eventually I'll give the answer, and, you know, if that's what you want. I mean, if you want to just continue to answer and continue to answer and continue to have discussions on it, that would be awesome if people would just have discussions on them. I even had a gentleman answer a question and explain to me why the question didn't make sense. And then I explained to him, I wish I remembered the question. I don't remember it right off the top of my head, but I explained to him face-to-face in a way that he was like, oh, okay, now it makes sense. So, like, you know, it's I want to get people talking. I want to get people learning. That's what we're trying to do. We're trying to teach and we're trying to learn. And, you know, it's all up to you. You got to make the strides. I'll put out the material. Laz will put out the material. We're going to give you everything that we can. It's up to you to go get it, you know, and if the lab doesn't make sense because we're moving too fast, let us know. Go read the book. You know, I highly recommend the Cisco Press books. That's how I got it. I used Laz's courses and I read. You got to understand the theory as well.
Yes, very, very, very well said. And it's true. And it's true. You have to read Cisco Press books. I mean, some yeah, you need to get it. Unfortunately, you need to get the Cisco Press books. There's other books out there that make it a little bit easier. Cisco Press is a very high dialect. It's very difficult to understand, especially no gain without pain. Look at Kevin. Boy, that's right, Kevin. That's the gym saying right there, baby. No gain, no pain, no gain. No pain, no gain, right? That is true. But the whole thing is that, yeah, Cisco Press is the book. They're the ones that are putting out the certification. So go straight to the horse's mouth. But also, always remember what I said. Read things critically. Read every word, every sentence, every paragraph. Get a good critical thinking mind when you're going through this. Because remember, this is not a technical book. It's a novel, according to Cisco Press. It's the opinions of the author. Not to talk bad about it. Just letting you know what it says in their disclaimer. Okay? But you do need to read. He's correct. You need to understand the concepts of everything. It's not just about syntax. You'll need to know the syntax, but it's not just about that. Okay? It's not just about that. You need to be very critical in what you're reading. But again, Bob Say, ladies and gentlemen, 10-year veteran, okay? Still working in the field, 10 years already in, okay? He knows what he's talking about. He's in the upper echelon. He worked his way up, okay? He's got his degrees. He's got his certs. He knows his stuff. He's got his stuff up on YouTube, on Facebook. Why aren't you checking his stuff out? Okay, let's go. Let's do what we need to do. All right, go to globed.net. Keep looking for his course. If you subscribe to globed.net, once his course goes up, you're going to get notified. Right? And I'm sure as hell going to be telling everybody about it. So, so definitely keep looking out for his stuff, because now you have two Cisco instructors on there. So,
and you can compare between the two of us.
Exactly. Exactly. What did he say? Oh, okay. That's what he meant. All right. I got it. And that's the way you do it. All right. But look for Bob. All right. He's coming soon. And Bob, thank you so much for taking time out today. I know it's during the week. I'm sorry. I know you're working. No, because you are, you know, you have your family, four kids. Whew, that's scary. Okay. But there is a wonderful family. I've seen your family. So, you know, I love them to death. Thank okay. You. And they're great. And be thankful for that as well. You're blessed because of that. Absolutely. All right. So again, just thank you so much for coming on board. Thank you for, you know, honoring us with your knowledge and our students, to help our students even more so. Okay.
Absolutely. I'm glad to do it. And I wanted to thank everybody for watching, and whoever is going to watch at a later date, because we are going to have this on my YouTube channel. And I think Laz might have it on his YouTube channel as well.
Oh yeah. It'll be on both channels. So on both, like, share, subscribe, hit the notification bell so you can get updates from both my channel and Bob's channel. Yep. And he's going to be doing lives as well. So look out for him. So you got two people that now, you know, dear and what is it? Near and dear to your heart. So, so keep up with us. All right. With that, I'll let everybody go. All right. I know Bob's got to do things. I'm inundated with a million things to do as well. So thank you so much for being here, Bob. Thank you, everybody, for taking the time out to listen to us. And let's just wait to see what the future brings. Cool?
Absolutely. Have a great day, everybody. Thank you.
Have a great day. Yeah, take care, everybody.